Koto, Nama Haida Mai, Ki Dene, Hui Akura. While we're waiting for Paul or Mrs. A, just a huge thank you to Jeremiah from Room 26 for sharing his music with us this morning. So during lockdown, he's been composing, recording some more music. Not the videos yet, but we look forward to hearing more from him. It just sounds so beautiful, a lovely way to start our morning. I see Mrs. O'Brien and Mrs. Kumar, Malia. Morena, the Vuni Fano. Good to see you guys. Oh, lovely waves there. So just the notice there around having the cameras on. I know sometimes the cameras aren't working or you don't want to share the fact you haven't been for a haircut for a while, but it really, for short assemblies, it's lovely to see your faces. And often if we have too many microphones on, we get all that back feeding stuff and it doesn't sound so good. So keep your microphones off. Children, if you can just remind your parents, if they're not listening now, to check Hero or their email for the return to school survey. And there has been some notices about starting school on Wednesday, and another notice, a big notice, will come out after this afternoon sometime.
Right. Mrs. A has asked me if I could just carry on for a minute while she's just sorting something out.
Fabulous.
So let's bow our heads for the school karakia. E te ariki.
Good morning, everyone. Well, what an exciting week with us being allowed to be back at school from Wednesday. We have a lot of celebrations of learning this week, so it will be over three parts. Let's watch the first part now.
Kia whakarono mai ki au I kore kore ana Ka whakaro ake a te aha E kore noa e tahi e re re ke Kia maki o pai tawhiti Aha ko te kokei He mana nui tō te aki Hei aha te whakaro I ti I tiro ki I tua tuara e Whakarono ki nā wai o roto e Kei wehi I te wehe nā I tō awa Tiro ki tua, tiro ki tua, tua Tua, tua, tua Tua, tua E koro koro tu I roto pākoro e Kia mai au e kore re re Hei I mohi o e nui no atura Tōku ora nai na te hira ira He ora nā nā kau kei tuara Kei tuara Tira ki tua tuara e Whakarongo ki nā wai o roto e Ke wehi I te wehe nā I tō awa I tō awa, I tō awa te kokei He mana nui tō te aki Hei aha te whakaruiti Ti tiro ki tua Yeah, yeah Ki tua Te wharua e
aha kua te aha mukore. Kia whakarono mai ki ou I kore kore ana, ka whakaro ake a te aha, e kore noa e tahi e rereke. Kia maki o pai tawhiti, aha ko te kokei, e mana nui tō te aki, hei aha te whakaritsi. I tiro ki tua tuarae, whakarono ki nā wai o roto e, kei wehi te wehe nā I tō awa. Tiro ki tua, tiro ki tua, tua. Tua.
So today I want to taste these two lemons, lemonade juice. Yeah, I'm going to taste them to see which one is the best. So, I'm going to taste this one first. Not too sweet, a little bit sour. This one's a bit too sour, and I didn't like how this lemon piece has seeds in it, and it's smaller than that one. So yeah, from the taste tests, the best I would say is this one.
That one. Good, but we don't know who owns it until the owner comes.
Yeah.
Maybe you can finish it. Thank you.
Can Fire Steph please share the narratives for this week?
Ora koutou katoa anō. If we can just back to the next slide, but hey, look, that learning. Really enjoyed seeing those books, the narrative stories that Room 29 have been doing. I think that might be through Book Creator, but either way, that looks fantastic. Good on you guys. Some of the seniors also had a session with Nanogirl Labs with, forgotten the name of the scientist, but she's really into Snapper. So obviously some kids have been motivated after that to learn more about Snapper. Interesting, I quickly saw that Snapper can live up to 60 years. So that'll be interesting to know how tasty they are or whether they just they pass their best. Really enjoyed also the fair testing aspect, because that's, you know, one of the key differences about science and other learning areas is that fair testing, making sure that when we do an experiment that we keep the conditions the same so that when we get a result, it's as true as possible. And I was really sad to hear about Charlie. So you might have seen Charlie, the little chick on the screen that the kids found at school, and they tried to keep him alive. But it's really hard. If a chick doesn't have its mum or somebody, you know, to feed it properly, then you're unlikely to survive. So well done, Bubble Class, for trying to keep Charlie alive. Okay, so again, that reminder about getting your parents to check Hero in email so that we can have everybody on the same page for Wednesday. Our focus is keeping everyone as safe as possible. So we have got some videos. Some of them are repeats. You'll have seen them before. But just, you know, give us a reminder before we start on Wednesday. Maybe I didn't proofread my own work here. Only adults who need to be on site should be, yes. Okay, so obviously the teachers and the support staff need to be on site, but we really don't want parents. However, parents, if any of your children do need you to come in with them, you may do that, but please be on site as least amount of time as possible. And do not come into any of the buildings, and keep your mask on and use the QR code. In the letter that comes out, or the pānui that comes out today, it talks about bubble classes. Each group of kids is in the same in a bubble with the same teachers, and they are not to mix with any other bubbles at all. So again, the letter will give you more information about that, and so will your class teacher. Your class teachers will send out information either today or maybe tomorrow about which bubble class you are in. So when you come to school tomorrow, via Melissa, via Sella, and myself will be at the Yates Gate. We will welcome you. We'll just check that you've got the right gear, you've got enough clothes to keep you warm, and if you are too hot as well, your sun hat, your sunscreen, your rain jacket, closed shoes. What else might you need? Your mask if you are year 4 to 8. Anyway, all of that is in the letter, and then you will go directly to class. And really, again, the main messages are wash your hands, wash your hands, wash your hands. You cannot wash your hands enough times, and make sure you dry them. And we'll just watch the videos now just to remind us of some of the other health and safety measures. Looking forward to seeing you back at school. And if you can't come back to school, again, your teachers will be in touch about what will happen with home learning. Thank you very much. Ka kite.
Through, and I miss you, the country's care. father. I'm glad to see you, but please leave me alone. If you need to talk, use your elbow. When you're feeling sick, you got to stay at home and stay out of my mice breath zone. I'll share my news, but my food's for me alone. If I smell your breath, I will go sit on my own. Always wash your hands, make them soapy full of foam, and stay out of my mice breath zone. If I can smell the juniper you had fat tea last night, then I'm going to toast to your face. I'll move to make it right. I like to hear you sing a song, but I don't like your spit. So be your good sport, keep it strong by moving back a bit. I'm glad to see you, but please leave me alone. If you need to talk, use your elbow. When you're feeling sick, you gotta stay at home and stay out of my mice breath zone. I'll share my news, but my friends want me alone. If I smell your breath, I will go sit on my own. Always wash your hands, make them so feel full of home, and stay out of my mice breath zone. I like to tackle and play with a side when it's break time. But now that's not quite safe enough. Don't touch and we'll be fine. I know you love my company, but I need my own space. You're not my shadow, stuck to me. Please get out of my face. I'm glad to see you, but please leave me alone. If you need to talk, use your elbow. When you're feeling sick, you gotta stay at home and stay out of my moist breath zone. I'll share my news, but my friends want me alone. If I smell your breath, I will go sit on my own. Always wash your hands, make them so feel full of home, and stay out of my moist breath zone. Just stay out of my moist breath zone.
Here's how to put on your face mask like a ninja. 1. Wash your hands with soap or sanitizer. 2. Make sure the mask you're about to put on is clean and has been washed with hot water and soap, dried and ironed, and placed in a new or clean bag. 3. Hold the mask by the strings and don't touch inside the mask. 4. Once it's fitted, make sure the mask covers your nose and your mouth. 5. Make sure you don't touch your face or fiddle with the mask. 6. If you have to adjust the mask, wash your hands, adjust the mask without touching your eyes, nose or mouth, and wash your hands again. And here's how to take off your mask like a superhero. 1. Wash your hands with soap or sanitizer. 2. Hold the mask by the strings and remove it from your face. 3. Wash the mask with soap and warm water, let it dry, iron it, and put it in a clean bag. 4. If you can't wash it now, safely store it in a bag until you can. 5. Wash your hands again with soap or sanitizer. Brilliantly done! Your face mask is your superpower to help you stay healthy and safe. So, make sure you look after it so that no viruses can come into contact with your nose or your mouth or your eyes. Be covered. Be safe. Be a hero.
Most people want to feel good more of the time. It's not always easy, but you could think of it like making soup. Like soup, your life is a combination of the ingredients you put in it. This sounds obvious, but if you change the ingredients, you will change the taste. It's weirdly easy to get stuck using ingredients you really don't like all that much. Just like you would check on your soup and taste it, you need to check up on yourself. This means doing your best to notice how what you do affects your thoughts and your mood. Sometimes what you add will taste great. Sometimes, not so much. Sometimes trying new things is just what you need. You could try a pinch of mindfulness, a cup of deep breathing, or a handful of tiny habits. If you're keen for some new ingredients, the Melon Manual has a bunch of things you can try. Check them out at melonhealth.com/manual. Most people
I've been staring at the edge of the water long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the light where the sky needs to see, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know. Just no telling how far I'll go. I know everybody on this island seems so happy on this island. Everything is by design. I know everybody on this island has a role on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine. I can lead with pride, I can make us strong. I'll be satisfied if I play along, but the voice inside sings a different song. What is wrong with me? See the light as it shines on the sea, it's blinding, but no one knows how deep it goes. And it seems like it's calling out to me, so come find me.
I would like to show you guys something that I like doing at home with my dad and my siblings. It is boxing. These are wraps. These protect your hands. There you go, class, this is my wraps. These are gloves for extra protection. Oh, Mom.
It's the one.
These are my gloves, the extra protection, and these are my gloves. These are my kick pads. You can also punch with it, but these are mostly for kicks. And these are my punch pads when my dad holds it and we punch it. I also go to a boxing gym on Wednesdays, 5 to 6. We do not. because it is locked down, we don't go training. We train home with my dad and my siblings. Please remember, we only train for exercise and self-defense. One of the most important things is discipline. We do not use this for violence. I would like to show you guys something that I can do. Sorry about that. It's my fault. We'll start over again.
No.
1-1-2. Front kick. 3-2-3. 1-1-2. Right knee. 3-2-3, son. Thank you.
Bye.
Son, you mean the
thank you. That was my show and tell. So, yeah, hope you guys are safe. Bye.
Yeah.
Morena, everyone that's here this morning. Just like to start off week five with a quote here. The pain you feel today will be the strength you feel tomorrow. And just like that, the weekend has gone. So for Monday, our Mindful Monday, so obviously we've been in lockdown for over 3 months, and it's all about your growth mindset as we transition from lockdown and coming back into school. So Mindful Monday, obviously, if you can see there, it's spell your name out. So use your name or whatever word you choose for each letter. You do the workout listed below. And heading off into Tuesday, so Transformation Tuesday. So so you and a buddy can have a coin each. So it's called like flip a coin workout. So if I asked the challenge, probably say Mrs. A, and we flip the coin at the same time. And if I got the heads and she got the tails, and then we would do each of those options there. So you got jump squats, calf raises, 60 seconds jogging on the spot on the same place. 25 jumping jacks, which are star jumps. And then you got the kneeling push-ups, standard push-ups, jumping jacks, 50 seconds, 40 high knees, and 40 jumping jacks. Heading into Wellness Wednesday, so there's a range of activities there. And it's always good to train with someone or just people from your whānau. So beat the trainer with kettlebell swings. We've got the slam ball rep beasts, just any type of ball you may have. Then you've got the push-up bleep test, the sit-up bleep test, plank pressure test, and a shuttle sprint grandmaster. Heading off into Thankful Thursday. So this is a quite a cool one. So it's kind of like a outdoor fitness circuit. And if you can see there, it pretty much gives you all the instructions. So everyone should still remember how to read. So it's got the setup and it's got the instructions there. So I'll let you read that in your own time. Oh, and then heading off into Friday is the dance day. You know, so use your own choreography or someone from within your whānau. And then, yeah, brings us the weekend. Weekend is here. Let's roll, baby. I'm ready for the weekend. And the dog on the right, oh, it's probably had too much. I'm ready for the weekend again. And other than that, thank you, Mrs. A, for, everything that you've done for our school. But, yeah, oh, sorry. And don't forget when you're working out to have your drink bottle, especially for the kids, no sharing of drink bottles, please. So make sure that you've always got your water bottle with you. Thank you.
Chaka haka toki te pi kore ro maui. E me na kana taku waha ki te kaya te rangatira. Takure o rangatira, taku kuru panamu tuku iho.
Thank you everyone for joining us assembly this morning. I look forward to being back at school safely from Wednesday. We will end this assembly with some videos. Please keep watching. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Rene. I'm the bike professor. I maintain and repair bicycles for my job, and that's why I get to see a lot of schools around the country. As part of that, I also see a lot of issues with stacking bicycles that bikes don't fit in a container. And we think we've got a solution for that. So now I'm going to walk down there and show you what we're going to do. So now we're going to go in here and we're going to stack some bikes correctly so you can see how much space you can create by doing them finely.
Hi there. So now we have to put the box inside the container. So as we do that, we make what I call stacks. So you lean the bike against the wall on the back, and it can be the back tire, can be the carrier, and you make sure the handlebars also touching. You have the bike fairly upright. To make it easier, I made these special frames. So now the bike actually leans very comfortably, very easy, so kids can deal with it better. So now I'm going to get some more bikes. All right, here we are again. So they've had it done once now, so let's see how I can do it the second time around. Excellent, that was lucky, wasn't it? All in the right place, nice and upright. Excellent. It wants to roll away, doesn't it? So turn the handlebar slightly more sideways. Here you go, now stop running away. Next one, please. Oh, the pedal has to come too. So which way is the pedal going? No, other way around. So you have to lift the bike up for a moment, lift the bike up, and then pedal. Okay. Here you go, that's fine. Next one, please. Yay. Good. Looking and thinking ahead, which way the handlebars have to go? And the pedal's in the wrong place. Pedal could be up, so lift up the back of the bicycle. Now lift it up and pedal forwards, yep, like that. Cool. And shunt it into each other. Good, handlebars the right way. Pedal's the right way. Oops, nope. Here you go. Lean too much. See the handlebars are going inside each other? Here we go. Okay, we're going to get some more bikes.
So this video is really, the bike professor has been to our school and he's helped us reorganize our bike sheds just to make them a bit more easier to use. And we won't get the bikes out straight away when we get back to school, but once we've got some routines in place, if we can do it safely, we will do that. So just for teachers to know that this is kind of the way our bike shed is now set up, and I've got some photos just to help. And I know the bubble kids have been using them, so hopefully they've learnt how to do this. So lots to look forward to in coming back to school. Look out for the Pānui this afternoon. And thanks everyone for that great video, great assembly. Jeremiah, Paul, Mrs. A, Miss Henry, Mrs. O'Brien, all the kids who shared their learning, the bubble class. Yeah, lots to be thankful for. Looks like it's going to be a better day today than the weekend. So, ka kite, stay safe, and we'll see you soon.
Cocky
day.
Bye. Cocky day. We close now. Because we heard.
Cocky day.
Jerk.
Jeremiah Burt. Bye.